Baseball is back. You had 4 days off for the All-Star break. What did you do over the break?
I enjoyed it with my family. We went to a lake a couple days, and we had a dinner party one night at the house, and had some mean card games with the kids, and we just enjoyed the family.
Are you able to relax at all, or are you still thinking, okay, this is what I have to do when I get back? Seattle's coming to town.
Well, you know, we had a little rain delay on Tuesday. We had some rain, so I did some work on Tuesday while it was raining because we couldn't be outside, and then I got back to work on Friday, so I really was able to enjoy it.
Do you have a tough time getting back into the swing of things when you have a little bit of time off coming back here?
No, it really isn't. When you come into the office, it's back to work. And actually, I thought Friday, the time that I was, you know, preparing for the game, it actually went slow. I was kind of anticipating getting started again and getting back to work, and I thought the time kind of went slow.
Now, you had the break off. I had the break off. Most players had the break off, but you had a couple who did not. Brett Gardner, his first All-Star game, and actually Dylan Betances got to pitch in this one. Did you watch?
I did. I had it on in the background as we were doing some things at the house and messing around, and it was good to see Dylan get in there and Tex get in there and Gardy get in there. And for these guys to have their first experience, Tex has played before, I think it was important for them, and I think Gardy's boys really enjoyed it.
Tex said that he thought this one meant almost as much as the first one, just because of what he had to do to get back to the All-Star game. Could you see that a little bit, his point of view on
definitely.
That?
Definitely. I think what he's been through the last 2 years in the battle that he's had with the wrist since he hurt it, it probably meant a lot. And, you know, his kids were probably a little bit, you know, old enough to enjoy it a little bit and take in the home run contest and really enjoy that as well.
While you love that they've been honored, does it make you nervous at all that they don't get the time off and they do have to play and get ready to play?
Yeah, it's kind of a catch-22. You want all your guys to be able to go when you want them to have great years and to have that honor, but you also want them to rest. And, you know, those three guys, their rest is shortened a little bit. They get late back late Tuesday night, early Wednesday morning. But they had 2 more days, and hopefully it works out well.
Well, everybody was back in action on Friday. 74 games left in the season. And if you look at the way the schedule shapes up, you have 40 of those games that were at home, 38 against divisional opponents. Do you look at things and say, we are 3.5 games up coming in? Our destiny is really in our own hands?
Yeah, it really is. And you look at, you know, we have the first 6 games at home, and then you go on a 10-day road trip where you play 10 games. You have 24 games on the road the rest of the time. So we're going to be home a lot. And I think that's important because we're so built for this ballpark.
And you're one of the only teams that doesn't have to travel to the West Coast at all, too, which I have to imagine is pretty nice.
Yeah, our longest trip is Texas, and that's the next road trip. And I think after the next road trip, we're only on East Coast time, which is favorable for our guys.
I believe Brian Cashman said a couple of days ago when asked whether or not you guys were going to make any trades at the deadline that getting guys like Jacoby Ellsbury back, Andrew Miller back, you can't make a trade as good as those guys are. And in addition, you'll also get Carlos Beltran back.
Yeah. You know, when you start adding guys that you had lost, it's like making a trade. And we were without, you know, Andrew and Jacoby for a fairly long time. Jacoby, I think, almost 40 games. So that's a long time. So to add those guys back in the lineup and Miller at the end of the bullpen, it makes our bullpen deeper. Shreve got some great experience, and so did Wilson, and we think our bullpen's really deep.
How do you see Beltran fitting into things again?
Well, he's going to play pretty much every day, what we expect him to do, and he feels good, and we need him to be productive.
He had a monster June, hitting 309 home runs, I believe, 23 RBIs. What do you think was the difference for him in the month of June?
I think he just got going, and we're going to need that from him as we move down the stretch, and you know, we're going to see some left-handers. So having a switch hitter really helps in those situations.
Rob Refsnyder called up during that Boston series, made his Major League Baseball debut that Saturday in Fenway. Sunday, hit his first hit, first home run. Had to be a pretty special day for the youngster.
Yeah, he had a lot of family and friends there. His fiance was there as well. And that first call up is so special. And I always tell the guys, make sure you take a minute to enjoy it because it's going to go real fast. It only happens once. That first call up only happens once. And to see him be productive, to play good defense, it was really nice to see.
A lot has been made about his defense. The beginning of the season at AAA, overall 13 errors, but the last 6 weeks prior to getting called up, just 2 errors. How different does he look defensively to you?
He looks a lot different than what we saw in spring training, and we think just the playing every day and getting the reps at second base has really helped. And he's probably played with a lot of different shortstops down there because there's a lot of moving parts because everyone seems to come up here because we've had some injuries. But he has improved a lot.
And do you think that takes a little bit of time just for him to get the chemistry with Didi Gregorius and the chemistry with other guys, the pitchers?
I mean, you have to figure out the range of your first baseman, the range of your shortstop, how he flips the ball when you're turning a double play, if he's going to be there on certain ground balls, you know, that are hit to you that maybe you're going to your right and you want to flip to second instead of going to first. So that chemistry takes a while.